going on, baby? This is your boy, the Sebastian Alexander Bonet, and welcome to another episode of The Audition. We are riding in the car in Palm Springs on my last day here. Shout out. Say hey.
Hey, what's going on, world? I'm Wesley from A-Connection TV, the network. How y'all doing?
This is my friend, my fellow vlogger, my mentor when it comes down to this thing that y'all see me do on YouTube. You know, I always mention Wesley. In returns to blogging and sizzle and a lot of gay events and all that good stuff, but we are out here in Palm Springs. This is the man that got me to come this year. Last year at Sizzle, he was selling it, come out to sunny Palm Springs and see the atmosphere, get the food, meet the people, and I can honestly say that I've had a good time in spite of my leg. Like, I think I would have had a better time if my leg didn't look like who the fuck did it and what for.
Right.
But I honestly have had a good time hanging out. Anytime I can hang out with Wes or even see Wes. And this ain't no bullshit, because y'all know I don't sugarcoat shit.
Right.
But anytime I can hang out with Wes, it's a privilege and it's an honor for me. So that in itself made the trip well. And I don't want to negate anybody else in the car as well. We got Sal over there.
Imperial, the hot boy.
Yeah, it's the Palm Spring boys. And then we have Carter over there driving, but we ain't going to show him too much because we want to live. So I can do this with all three of us right here. So, Wes, what is your favorite part? Or it's over now. The bitch is dumb. Latino always is 2014. Okay. It's a wrap. What was your favorite? Oh, hold on. Before I go there, shout out to my boy Wes one more time, because he was honored yesterday. I was not able to attend because I just wasn't feeling well with my leg. He was honored with the 2014 Latino Oasis King Supporting Kings award ceremony yesterday. It's pretty much an award ceremony for that Joe Hawkins puts on, to where he honors members of the LGBT community for what they do, be it media, be it promoting, be it HIV/AIDS activism. It's just saying thank you for the work that you do for making our community a better place to live, learn, teach, and just experience. So he received one yesterday. What was your, did it have a title for yours?
No, it was just appreciation from the group King Supporting Kings. So it didn't say like the best blogger or well-known, popular, whatever. It wasn't like a title like that. But it was just a recognition award for what I do contributing to our community, which was just an astounding moment for me, because any kind of recognition from people within our community is a beautiful situation. So the fact that they went out of the way to, you know, create the award and to do the ceremony, and I wasn't the only one honored. We have people like Samson, Kyle Jeffrey, Narelle Apparel. He was there. Narelle, he was there. There was quite a few people that got honored, and it was just nice, because at that ceremony, everybody was mature, everybody was adult. It was just a real grown-up event. So yeah, I had a great time. But my most memorable and favorite moment of this particular trip would have to be, and it's hard because I've had like at least 7 or 8 great moments, but it would definitely have to be the first night that I got to meet Kevin and Bronny. And it was myself, Sal, Kevin, Bronny, and Harold. We completely cut up that night, had a great time. The manager at the La Jolla whipped out his dick and tried to get Kevin and Sal to suck it, or them suck his dick.
Are you serious? Like
that. What?
Yes, God, honey.
It was crazy. He just was going around. This is the manager.
Is he like an old man or a young man?
He was old. He just comes out with
now, question, out. Was it nice?
No. It was white, no offense.
I mean, you can't be offense because you're white.
There's no offense.
I'm Sicilian. You're Sicilian. Picture it. Sicily, 1922. Yeah, Sophia. Okay.
It was just, you know, it was a white.
That was a weird situation. So when it was just an awesome night of cool drinks and just great camaraderie with the people. And then, of course, I filmed a lot. So that was great. And hosting this event was awesome. So I had some great memories.
Okay, that's the business. So, okay. Wow. My manager didn't do nothing like that for me at my hotel. No, I wish the housekeeper would have. Oh, baby. What was his name? Joaquin?
Was hot.
Yeah. Baby. He's, what was he like? And he had like the little baby hair pressed down right here and it was braided all the way. Yeah, that bitch was sexy.
All right.
What was your favorite part, Sal?
My favorite part. You know, I would say the first night, but also. I think the pool party was a lot of fun. I think that was like the sun, the drinks, the boys. It was actually an amazing time. The music, the strippers, the performance was insane on stage. It was something that you would probably not see anywhere else unless you actually come to Patino Oasis. But I'm sure a lot of people put it on YouTube already, or it's all over Vista.
Oh yeah, she on my Vista. YouTube, shut your shit down.
Yeah, I mean, it was crazy. I mean, if you go to Vista and you guys see all that, I mean, that's like exactly what happened. But once you see it in person, it's different when you see it in a video, because you actually get the actual experience right in front of your eyes, and you kind of have, like, look at it, and your mouth drops, because you're just like, I don't know, it's just the adrenaline rush with everybody else being around. It was actually a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. I loved it. I'm definitely coming next year. And the year before that. Going to Sizzle, that's for sure. I'm definitely going.
And the year before that would be this year's style.
If you're next to that, so. Yeah. I'm a little bit injured right now.
I mean.
So my mind is like not really on it, but
it's okay.
A little bit dropped out, but
I wouldn't try.
That's just what friends are for. Correct you.
I didn't want to correct in front of the people.
We help each other out. This is a family. Yeah. We help each other out. You know what I mean?
This is a unique
situation
amongst individuals in the LGBT community, and I don't know. I like bringing people together to see how we all connect, and that's the thing. The foundation of my channel. Adopting similar connections despite our differences. And for the most part, you would have to say that you met some great people.
Yeah, oh yeah, I agree.
And would you agree to that as
well? Oh yeah, most definitely.
I love traveling, and I think life is too short. So if you are fortunate enough and blessed enough to step out of your state at least, and I'm not saying driving to the next state to see your grandmother or your mama. I'm saying get your ass on a plane and just go somewhere. If you're able to do that, or at least save the money to do that, then do that. Because once you travel, then it allows you to get a more a fuller scope of what life can be or what it is supposed to be for you.
Yeah,
or at least
yourself,
that's how I look at it. Yeah.
Self-discovery of who you are.
Right.
When you learn what you like, you learn what you don't like. You kind of, I travel the world and I'm learning each day what I like, what I don't like. And I'm like evolving each day. I'm growing as a person. So traveling is a great experience. It gives you, like, being multicultured is actually a great way to self-discovery. But also, when you want to meet someone, you're kind of have a full scope of what life is all about.
Right.
Well, that's the business. That's the business. You know, for me, it has been a exciting weekend. Everybody knows, especially on my channel. See, Wes is very classy. Jesus. Wes is very classy with his channel. You know, he has all of the, you know, he has Mona Simone and
Twan
Rose and all that good stuff. Just different personalities with full stories. For me, y'all pretty much know that I'm just a whore. I'm just a good old-fashioned whore from the Bible, the woman at the well. Honey, that's just me. And I came to have my back broken, and needless to say, it didn't happen. I blame it on my leg, because, honey, if I was in my prime, bitch.
Yes, God.
Ooh, the dicks I would have rolled. The dicks that, oh, my God, my God, my God. But I'm saving it now, because at this point, I didn't do anything as well. Let me say this. I wasn't the bottom this weekend. Did you catch that message? Ooh. Hey, God. Ooh. Now, I wasn't the bottom, but I did get...
Now, you know, it was very interesting that you told me that you did indulge in some sexual situations, and I'm like, with that leg, child.
Bitch, camouflage. You didn't see me. Hold on. Well, you
saw it.
Yeah, bitch.
I saw it.
On the way, okay. On the way,
that on pants.
Yes, God, sweatpants.
Yeah, it was wrapped around, and then he had a big shoe to fit it.
Camouflage. Bitch, I had on shorts on the way coming. I said, bitch, let me run by Walmart and get me some sweatpants. Bitch, I went by Walmart and got me them sweatpants, baby.
Yeah, it was good. He did a good job.
Because you know that unfortunately within our community, you know, I just have a, like an infection or whatever. But you know, ooh, what the hell is that? A bird? People look at my leg and think I got the bubonic plague or something like that, that is contagious. And it's about, you know, it's about looks within our community. So, bitch, I camouflaged her, and I went in and got me a little nip. And then the nip that I got came back, and then I nipped a little more. So, I mean, I can't say that I did not have any activity. It wasn't the activity that I was coming for. But let me ask you this, and we're going to go. Do you find it true, West and South, that people stereotype your sexuality, no, your, not sexuality, your position based on looks?
Wow, give me,
And I mean like
based
top,
on looks?
Like if I looked at Sal, what I say, is he a top or bottom? If I looked at Reggie.
Oh yeah, we do that all the time.
Yeah. I mean, it depends. Like some people actually know me. So when they know me, they already know what I like. Some people don't, so they ask me, or they, you know. So I mean, I like both, really. I mean, there is one particular I like more than the other.
And that is for the kids to know.
Huh?
And that is for the kids to know.
Why did
they know? I just wanted
to know. Hit me up, right? It's on Facebook. You can follow him, follow me somehow.
Don't give the kids your government, baby. Don't give them no Facebook. Give them your Instagram.
I don't need to, tell the whole world.
Shit, this is called private road.
I mean, I do like...
Yeah, you're going the right way.
Yeah, just go straight.
It's not like a military...
That was what I was about to say.
About to get shot up. Terrorists and shit.
Like an alien.
Oh, look, it's the bear.
Smokey.
Hey, Smokey.
Already been attacked by a bear.
Sure, ain't no trees. What the fuck gonna catch you on fire? But okay, so what about you, Wes?
The same question.
Yeah.
When people look at me naturally they think I'm just a top, but I'm not just a top. I'm a burst. And that's what I like. But yeah, I think when people get to know me more, they see more of a bottom tease than a top tease. But that's when I just like to cut up and cut a rug. Okay. But normally, I'm top tees all day. Normally.
See, and that was, okay. And the reason why I asked that, we're about to get up out of here, because we're about to go ride the motherfucking mountain.
Yes, indeed, baby.
Babe, I'm going to have video of this shit. And when
it, show them how close it is.
Oh, I'm going to turn around. Look at the mountains, hoes. look out. Ain't that what God created, baby? This is beautiful. That shit can fall at any minute, honey. You need to know Jesus going up this bitch. But every time people look at me, they think I'm a top. They think that, you know, I'm a big, burly black man and that I be putting down the dick. And when I do, bless you. But I prefer to be a bottom. My thing is, I want to be the three H's. A happy whole housewife. And I can't find a man to do that. I want to be the man to... You know, take the dick, make sure your breakfast and your dinner and all that stuff is ready, and lay out your clothes at night, and make sure the bills are paid with your money. Now let's be clear. I'm gonna work too, but if I'm gonna be the happy old housewife, you need to provide. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, but anyways, that's what the dude I met last night. Well, Saturday night, he just figured I was a top. You know, and the thing that gets me, okay. Anyway, so we about to go because we about to go ride this mountain once again. This is your boy, the Sebastian Alexander Bonet. Thank you for definitely tuning in. Say bye, Wesley.
Later, people. Check out my channel on A Connection TV. Google me.
And what's your Instagram song? Because you know the kids gonna hit you every time I have somebody on here new. Which, see, he shares shit. I don't never share none. It's just me. So how can we get in contact with you?
It's Kingsta07. So it's King and then STA07.
Kingsta07 at Instagram. Bye, Carter. No, you pay attention, bitch.
Keep playing with me.
Bye, Carter. All right, we'll talk to y'all later. Peace and much love. Ciao.